get over how beautiful the Midlands are. Such natural colors. You say the Downs are different.
Yeah.
How?
See for yourself.
Oh, my.
Terrons.
Here in the Downs? They're a long way from home. Maybe we should turn around here. I didn't think so. What is it? Horses? Fresh?
Yeah.
That'll be their campsite. We should turn around now.
No, it's too white. It's not a campfire.
White smoke? Why does it have to notice everything? White smoke? I don't even know what white smoke is. I don't want to know what white smoke is. Ugh.
I brought you something. Here you are. Here, take them. I have one for each of you. Where's the other?
Over there!
Extraordinary legend. The story of a warrior who communicates with animals. Who fights sorcery and the unnatural. His name is Dar, last of his tribe. He's also called Beastmaster.
Thank you. the blood of a creature I once saw. A magnificent creature.
Blue. That's odd.
Terrons were here.
That makes sense. Terrons have a history of slaughtering magnificent creatures.
There's a tiger here, too.
They probably killed that as well.
No, it's alive. Terrans went that way, and the tiger followed.
The Terrans had a tiger with them? That doesn't make sense. And maybe the Terrans were hunting, and they made a kill, and the tiger stole it.
No. The tiger came after. You see, tigers are the protectors of the animals with blue blood.
That's rare. Well, with the possible exception of Rue, I've never heard of tigers protecting any other animals.
That's because this is a very rare and very magical animal. What I saw was probably one of the last ones left in this world.
Put down your weapon. Kill that one.
Take aim.
You must be joking, Dar!
You've chosen the wrong time to hunt the wrong animal.
We weren't hunting.
And now you've chosen the wrong time. It's a lie. We have the poachers. Take them to the castle.
There.
At least you're unharmed. For that, I'm grateful. Calm yourself.
It's all my fault.
No. And don't ever believe that.
They never would have come if I didn't call them.
Which is as it should be. The legend is clear. The unicorns and their magic only appear to the pure of heart, such as you. And you can't blame yourself for the treachery of others.
Who would harm them? Who would do such an awful thing?
We found the men. They'll be punished, and all will be safe again.
I want to see them.
Why? They're common hunters with no regard for the sanctity of life.
I want to look in their eyes. So I know the faces of evil.
Fetch the prisoners!
These are the men, m'lady. Wretched as they are.
How could you kill such a beautiful and harmless animal?
Begging your pardon, but we didn't.
He's lying.
We are peaceful. We're very caring towards wild animals, certainly not killers of them.
We caught them right at the spot.
It's true. But we only discovered the place where the animal was killed. The animal was nowhere to be seen.
Do you have anything to say?
Only my friend is telling you the truth. Like he always does.
This is his weapon, lady. Does it look like he's telling the truth? You've stolen the joy from our princess and our kingdom. Your punishment is the same as you granted the unicorn.
death.
You're making a mistake. We didn't kill the unicorn.
Yeah, tell it to the angel.
Why'd you throw us in here? What are you gonna do?
It's very simple. We boil the oil. Our cook pours it in, and then you boil. A horrible death. I don't even like to watch it.
Goodness, idiots! We gotta find a way out of here, fast. We're running out of time, Dar. I gotta think.
The walls are too smooth to climb.
It's far too high to jump. We better figure something out fast.
You have no patience.
Well, I have more patience if they weren't getting ready to boil us like chickens. We gotta find a way out of here.
If I find out he's eating when our lives are in danger, there's gonna be big trouble.
Potto! Potto!
We have a plan.
Oh, goody. What are they gonna do? Bring us a ladder?
Tao, you know you'd only fall off it.
You promised three horns. Do my eyes deceive me? Are two of them invisible, or have you brought only one?
Had your men waited, you would have all three. They were careless.
Terrons? Careless?
I take that as a compliment.
But our arrangement was, I get three horns, you get to dispose of your princess and take over the kingdom. I'm disappointed. And I don't like disappointments.
The horns are more powerful than you think, King Zed.
So I've heard, and yet so far I've seen nothing.
Then perhaps a small demonstration would ease your momentary disappointment. For a great king, whose armies are always in battle, this has a priceless quality. Do you trust me?
No.
You will.
Watch!
Alive. I'll breed them, and I'll be invincible. Every Terran warrior will have a priceless horn.
So to speak.
It's hot. It's hot. No Of all the things I've ever done, of all the trouble I ever got into, I never thought the end would come like this!
Tell you, calm down. We still have time, and we now have help.
Well, you have more faith than me!
You worry too much.
Well, right now my life depends on 2 four-legged furballs. I should worry!
Ladder, didn't you?
I'm gonna start believing in miracles.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Just make sure it's tight first. Come on, let's go.
Surprises. But please don't make me wait too long.
All right. Abracadabra, open your eyes.
I don't believe it. What have you done?
Do you remember what I told you about human emotions? How they can get under your skin?
Yes.
Well, no one is immune. Ever since I took that young girl. Now, what was her name?
The Beastmaster's woman, Kyra.
Ah, that's the one, yes. Ever since I placed her in here, I felt her youth, her beauty, her love. And I went along with it. Frivolous, perhaps, but growing younger certainly has its advantages.
Yes, but how did you do it?
Oh, it's quite simple, really. I believe that if one can grow old, why can't one grow young?
You have to teach me.
In time.
There's something else I'd like to know. If I could look, what else would I see in there?
Confusion.
You tease me. Why do you do that?
But it's true. There's the past, the future, the present, parallel worlds, the Big Bang, the second Big Bang, and the one to come. There's even wormholes. It's all terribly confusing.
If you're growing younger, living your life backwards, then I won't be able to call you the Ancient One any longer.
Oh, good point. What about the Not-So-Ancient One? That'll do for the time being. Ah, company.
The Beastmaster's eagle again. It's been coming here, and I have no idea why.
He's haunting you, my dear. Haunting you.
I take back every nasty thing I've ever said about you two. I take it back twice.
I'm just glad to be leaving this little just place.
Can't leave yet.
Why?
I want to save the princess and the unicorns.
What?
You said yourself, Tal. If the animals are slaughtered, then they'll disappear from the world forever.
That princess agreed to kill us.
No. She didn't know the truth.
You amazed me. I mean, these people, they attack us, accuse us of a terrible deed, throw us into a filthy pit, and then they threaten to kill us with burning oil, and you want to help them?
Right.
Well, I can't think of any other reason why I want to stay around here and risk my life.
I can.
What?
Someone has my staff.
You've lost one unicorn, but you still have the other two to consider. And your kingdom.
I feel like they were betrayed.
On your behalf, I make myself aware of everything that takes place in the kingdom. If there was a betrayal, I would have known about it.
I'm so glad you're here, Chancellor. I don't know what I'd do without your help.
It is my duty and my privilege. Go to your unicorns. They need you now, more than ever.
But it's not safe.
We have the poachers. I promise you, the danger has passed. Forth your magical animals, and look well, because when they come, I'll close your eyes forever.
The signal. No, Princess. I have another plan. And something else to do.
You killed the unicorn.
Yes. But don't worry about those two. They'll be kept alive. However, you aren't so fortunate. In the real world, Princess, there's no room for the pure of heart.
You can't do this. You'll be caught. My people. We'll never believe you.
Oh, yes, they will. When I tell them the two poachers escaped for a short time and use this to kill their princess as well.
No!
sorry. I'm so sorry that had to happen. Are the other two unicorns alive?
The Terrans took them, with his help. They're the most beautiful creatures in the whole world. And they have these magical powers. Their horns can heal the sick and the wounded.
Actually, that makes sense. King Zad is constantly having wounded inside his camp. Everyone knows the Terrans are very sick.
He did take them alive.
I'm not sure, but it doesn't matter. The unicorns are supposed to be free. When they're held in captivity, they die.
They're probably heading for the Terran camp.
It's not a good place to go.
Well, do you have a better idea?
We can think of some in time.
We don't have any time.
I'm going with you.
No.
They're my creatures. They won't come to anyone. Only to those whom they were promised. And to the pure of heart.
Well, I guess that leaves out you and me, huh?
Come on, let's go. Let's go.
I will say this to you once and once only. So I beg you listen very carefully. Apparently this is something that you have a great deal of trouble putting into practice. All things have a perfect time and place in life. Joy is balanced by sorrow, day by night, giving by receiving, and wisdom by humility. The secret of life is living it in balance, in harmony and honor with that which surrounds you. This is madness! I swore that you would never walk this earth again. But you will, if only for the blink of an eye. That's better. Now, tell me, Shirak, how does it feel to have arms once more instead of wings?
It's been a long time.
A couple of 100,000 years? A mere trifling in time. But don't hold your breath until it happens again.
What difference would it make? You've condemned me to live forever.
Oh, and I can make it worse. In fact, I've told the sorceress everything. I knew a young sorceress who tasted human emotions. She fell in love. Another sorcerer stole her heart. They experienced the entire rainbow of human emotions.
But I thought they were forbidden for others like us.
Oh, they are. And the punishment was most severe. He was condemned to immortality, given wings and put into the sky. There he lives with the full sad memory of his folly.
And the other?
The memory of her lover. And her emotions were taken away. Gone forever. Like yesterday.
Why do you punish us like this?
Because you came to me, bright young minds, begging to know the secrets of the universe. I accepted that. I believed in you both. But you threw it all away. What for? Love?
Any human beings would have done the same. We're not perfect.
Perfect? No one breathing today's air is even close.
So then why the big speech about harmony and balance? Isn't love part of that?
Oh, come, Shirak. You chose to enter the womb of creation and find out its meaning. When you make an excursion like that, you leave emotions at the door.
I only went to her because one of her creations, the unicorns, are about to be destroyed.
Her problem. None of your concern.
Then explain to me what I'm supposed to do. Wander the sky and never try to see her again? Tell me, and tell me the truth.
The truth needs no explanation, only reflection. So reflect on that for a few centuries.
It's getting dark. The Terrans will be making camp soon.
I suggest we do the same. We can try to surprise them in the morning.
No. Unicorns will never survive a whole night. They need to be free.
So how did you come to know these unicorns?
Well, there was a sickness. It spread throughout the Downs. It killed my mother and father. But they were good and generous people. A sorceress created the unicorns to help us and protect us from the sickness. But no one was to see or know about them except for the...
The pure of heart.
That's right, but I am no longer that. I have hatred and anger in my heart now.
But some emotions are correct. You were betrayed by evil. That does not make you evil, too. How are the tigers related to the unicorns?
The demons of the forest asked the tigers to protect the unicorns.
Oh, I see. I see. And the Terrons have tried to kill all the tigers, so consequently there's less of them, and consequently less unicorns as well. Oh, whoa. What's wrong?
Unicorns. They're dying. I can feel it.
We gotta move quickly.
Chancellor, you brought me what you promised?
Not yet. But if you grant the pleasure of traveling with me, you'll have more than you asked for this night.
And how do I know that?
Let me show you I'm a man of my word.
That's a very healthy attitude, Chancellor.
I've tricked the princess. Your men have the unicorn. She's following them. They'd be here by now, only they travel slowly with the animals. If you come with me, you'll not only be able to take the unicorns, but the princess as well.
I understand she's quite attractive.
And young, if you know what I mean.
Wait for me outside.
You know, I've been so concerned about the unicorns, I didn't even ask your names.
I'm called Dar. He's Tal.
My name's Jessica. You could have died because of me. I should have believed you.
It wasn't your fault.
Jessica. That's a pretty name.
It comes from an old tribe.
Oh, really? What's its meaning?
It means a god who sees.
Or a goddess who sees unicorns. What is it? Oh, it's all right. It's Oli Roo. He's a friend of ours. What does he want?
We're close. It's this way.
Unicorns will only come to me.
Unicorns? Amazing. I never thought I'd see them.
You won't see one alive. They're not free still. The glow which gives them life is fading.
All right. Come on and signal you. Not before.
But... I must trust him.
What is he going to do?
I have no idea. But he knows what he's doing. Usually.
What is it?
What's this? The Beastmaster?
Yes.
The two unicorns on the Beastmaster's head. King Zed will be very pleased. What do you want?
You took two animals that don't belong to you.
It's no concern of yours.
All animals are a concern of mine.
Not these.
I would appreciate it if you would give them back.
You dare to come to us, alone, and you make demands?
Oh! I don't want to fight you. And no, I didn't come along. The protector of the unicorns has come with me.
And he'll die with you.
So like I said, I don't want to fight you. But Rue, well, he's very angry at what you've done. And so are his friends.
There's still more of us.
More of them.
Beastmaster, take the unicorns. You can have them.
I know. But I don't think my friends have finished with you yet.
Beastmaster!
We should leave quickly. There could be more Terrons nearby.
Come on, hurry.
These are the men who took the unicorns. I don't understand.
I do. You're not a man of your word.
What are you doing? What's that for?
Protection. The king never knows when he might be wounded by betrayal. You betrayed me, Chancellor. You must listen to me. I don't know what happened here, but I had nothing to do with it.
I gave you one of the horns. For that... You must have mercy!
No unicorns, no princess. No mercy.
Sir, I beg you.
Use the horn.
I shall.
That's a beautiful sight, huh? I'm so glad we stayed to help. Ah, looks like we're gonna get wet. Probably afraid of the lightning.
No, it's a warning.
Warning? What kind of a warning?
What's happening? They've never been frightened of weather before.
It's a sorceress. It's the one who created the unicorns.
The sorceress? What is she doing?
She's taking them away.
No! She can't do that! Why?
Because they're not safe here anymore. There'll always be someone who wants to use them for the wrong reason.
Then why take them? Their magic brings joy and life to the kingdom. Why destroy that?
She's taking them someplace safe. Somewhere where you'll always know where they are.
How do we know that? How do I know it's true?
Because it is.
See. Now you and everyone else will always see them too.
You were right.